Hey everyone, SilentCiel here. Welcome back to another video of Pokemon Sun with me. So, we're gonna continue off from where we stopped. So, it seems like every game there will be like a Pokemon doll. So, the previous game's Pokemon dolls used to be Clefairy, but this time around it seems to be a Clefairy. Murkrow? It's rather puny compared to what we see in the anime. It's a very huge fish tank. Okay, so where are we supposed to go? I can't really remember. Whoa, it even has a battling gym area. Also, I guess this tube leads to the fish tank up the stairs. So pretty useful information if you guys aren't familiar with how Pokemon battle system works. Alright, let's get out of here. So I guess we're not supposed to stay here anymore. Exit this way. So I wonder where we're supposed to go next.
Oh, Wingo. Do I have Pokeballs? Yeah, I do. Okay, let's try to catch a one. Oh no! There we go. So we've got grass and water covered. But both of them are flying types. Oh, cool. So now Rotom comes out and tell you how many percent you've actually completed. Oh, that's something interesting.
So yeah, here we go.
Alright, we're gonna skip on this one. What? No, go away, shoo. Let me run. Goodness. No. I guess Rowlet is not fast enough to escape from Wingull. Okay, so I guess you probably can use Surf around here, but we don't have a surfing Pokemon yet. It's too early in the game. I'm gonna evade the grass as much as I can. Once again, too slow. Okay, I'm home, so I think I'll better get my mom to heal up my Pokemon. The really cool thing about the game now for Sun and Moon is that the Pokédex acts as a map. So as you're running, the icon actually falls onto the map. That's pretty cool. Yeah. So if you're the kind of person who get lost easily, I guess we have an active, continuously active GPS system. I guess this is the site towards my home as well. Might be wrong. Seems like it. Yeah, leads back home. So I got lost. A lot of bird types here. I'm wondering if the Pokemon Sun and Moon game actually still follows like X and Y, where each Pokemon you capture the EV stats are also added to the Pokemon that you have active. So if you guys have actually watched the first episode of Pokemon Sun and Moon anime, you would know that Lydia's personality in the anime and in the game are somewhat different. In the anime, she seems a bit more shy and very, very timid towards Pokemon. Right? In the game, she seems okay. Yeah, it's cool that we have a cafe now. Very hip. Wild Taurus on the street. Okay, so we finally got EXP share. I completely forgot I'm supposed to narrate the thing. Oh well, it's fine. I guess you probably do not want to hear me talk. I mean, read. Why is she standing right beside an incinerator? A critical hit. That wasn't necessary, but okay. Oh, the EXP share is on. Okay, I'm gonna switch off the EXP share because I don't think it's necessary. Let me see, how do I do that? Is there like a shortcut button? I'll turn it off. There we go. Alright, so I have to find 3 more students to defeat. No. Pokeball. So I guess this is the second student. No, he's not. Okay, so I'm gonna go in, I guess. I have a feeling she's one of them. Yeah, there we go. For someone so little, she definitely has some fighting spirit. Oh. So is this like a preschool? Oh, quick call. Alright, so we're gonna attach Quick Claw to Rowlet. Okay, there we go. Sorry that you guys can't see what I'm doing. Nothing in this room.
So this is the side exit. So I guess we have to go up.
Oh, how many levels does this school have? Oh, look at the slope. Even has his own bed.
The bed looks like a sofa from this angle.
Oh, cool.
So, not on this level as well.
Okay, I guess we can't go up. So where are the other three? I mean two. We've already defeated the preschooler. So there should be another one. Not here. No. I guess this boy here. There we go. So, I'm still considering which Pokemon to have in Sun and Moon as my main team of six. But usually for me, when it comes to fighting the Elite Four, but apparently this game there is no Elite Four, I guess. So, it's gonna be a totally different format of Pokemon. Usually what I do with all the other games is I basically use only my starter from start to end. So apparently I don't think I can do that for this game since there's no Elite Four. So learning a move Astonish. Let's see. What does Astonish do? I cannot remember.
User attacks the target while shouting in a startling fashion. This may also make the target flinch. It's a physical move with a power of 30 and 100% accuracy. It's a ghost type attack. Huh, ghost, eh?
Okay, so I think I'm gonna remove Growl for Astonish. It's always good to have different types of attacks just in case.
I kind of feel bad for taking money from kids, you know.
What in the world is this? Whoa.
So yeah, I'm still thinking which Pokemon to have in my team of six. So you'll slowly see my Pokemon appear in the
video images, just like
how I have Rowlet there for episode 2,
part 2. Yeah. So I guess he's he is the last one. So
the biggest kid will always be the toughest, I guess.
Uh. Oh, Grimer. Now, even though his Alola form is unique, but I still find it gnarly. Alright, so he's a poison type. I can't really remember poison. Is ghost effective against poison? I can't recall. Let's just give it a try. The animation is so cute. Okay, so it's not effective at all. I shouldn't have. Oh well. I can't recall. It's been so long since I remembered the Pokemon type list. Alright, so I'm gonna go with Leaf Edge. Dang. Oh no. Oh no. I got a bad feeling. Rowlet might get knocked out the next turn. If he does a bite. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna die. What should I do? I should switch out. I only have a potion. Yeah, I should switch up. Okay. Just gonna make use of whatever I have. Let's see, Wingull is probably the best thing that I have. Oh wow! Okay, so Grimer is pretty badass in the Alola side. Oh boy. Okay, so I'm just gonna use Wingull to take the hit while I heal up my Rowlet. Thank you, Wingull. Alright. Oh my goodness. And of all the times, thank you. It could have been... If I had attacked instead of using Wingull, would I have gotten a critical hit? I doubt so, but yeah. Huh, that's cool. She doesn't believe me. Oh my goodness, that's just terrible. Okay, so second floor we shall go. Whoa. Alright, let's go for it. Two Pokemon, eh? Uh-oh. Good thing I'm a grass type as well. This looks bad. I don't think I'll be able to survive this battle. Because I haven't really been training. We've just been following the story as... Yeah. Oh no. Alright, so I guess potions come in handy. It feels like I'm kind of cheating, but can't be helped. I don't think pet would do anything, but let's give it a try. Okay, that was really, really pathetic. Okay, I'm regretting using pet now. Okay, we'll definitely need to heal up here. Alright, cool! Whoa, twice in a row! Fantastic! Level up. Cool. So her meow should be the dark version. Oh man! Is ghost effective against dark? I can't really recall. Let's give it a try. Okay. Flinching is very annoying. I mean, if it's against my opponent, I guess it's pretty cool. But when it's against me, that really sets me back. Alright, so let's give Astonish a try and see whether it's actually useful. Okay, so apparently not. Oh man! Can I still survive one more hit? I hope I do. Yeah, I do. Oh no! Oh boy. If you're wondering why I'm not using my other Pokemon to fight, it's because most of them are like level 4 and 5. They'll do nothing against this level 9 Meow. Stop flinching me! Please let this hit knock it out. There we go. She gave me great balls. Alright.
how many people do I have to fight in this school?
Oh, so he's the one that's blocking us from moving onward. So that's the end of school for me. I wonder if this is the Taurus that we're gonna be riding on. So we're gonna pet the Taurus. I hope he doesn't attack me. But we didn't even touch the Taurus. Alright guys, so I'm gonna end the video here. I'll see you guys in the next part of Pokemon Sun. Bye!